Hello everyone, in today's video I'm going to show you how to turn your video into a circular talking head inside Camtasia studio like this. So let's dive into the video to see how this can be done. Here you can see I have recorded a short video with myself in the camera. In order to turn this rectangular video into a circular talking video, we need to proceed as follows. First, you need to come over here on the timeline, right click and separate audio from video. Now you can see your audio is on the top of your camera. So you need to take your camera on the top of your audio. For this, you need to come onto the track 2, right click, go to move track and click on up, and here we go. Now the camera is on the top of your audio. In the next step, you just need to spread this rectangular video onto the whole screen and leave it there. Further, you need to go to annotations, all, and here you can go to this round callout and drag it onto your screen. Now you can hold control and shift key together and spread it out evenly onto the top of your face. Now you can come onto the timeline and spread this call out to the length of your entire video. Lastly, you need to go to more, into visual effects, and here you can see we have this media mat option. You can just grab it, hold it and bring it onto your call out. And here we go. You can see that our video turned into a circular talking head. Now you can either grab from these handles and reduce the size of this circle. Now in the next step, you just need to select both the callout and the camera together, right click and group them together. Now you can come onto your screen and hold the screen from the corner and bring it down like this, and now you can place it anywhere onto your screen. Further, you can just right click on your circular talking head, go to add visual effects, into drop shadow, and here you can increase the offset. I think offset around 18 is enough. Now you can see there is a drop shadow underneath this round talking head, which gives the feeling of a three-dimensional object. If you are working on a project and you have to use this media mat and annotation again and again, you can just move them into your favorite. Right click over them and you can move them into your favorite. Since I have already moved them into my favorites, so it's asking me to remove from there. You can see inside favorite, I have kept this callout as well as this media mat, and from here you can use them with ease. I hope you have learned something new in this video. If so, please give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching.